During the first month, the dice had rather small effect on my life. I used them to choose ways to spend my free time, and to choose alternatives when the normal I didn't particularly care. They decided that Lil and I would see the Edward Albee play rather than the Critics Award play, that I read work X selected randomly from a huge collection, that I would cease writing my book and begin an article on why psychoanalysis usually fails, that I would buy General Envelopment Corporation rather than Wonderfield Industries or Dynamic Go Company, that I would not go to a convention in Chicago, that I would make love to my wife in Kama Sutra position number 23, number 52, number 8, that I see Arlene, that I don't see Arlene, that I see her in place X rather than place Y, and so on. In short, the secret of the successful dice life is to be a puppet on the strings of the die.
You should learn not to make personal remarks, Alice said with some severity. It's very rude.
The Hatter opened his eyes very wide on hearing this, but all he said was,
Why is a raven like a writing desk?
Come, we shall have some fun now, thought Alice. I'm glad they've begun asking riddles. I believe I can guess that, she added aloud. Do you mean that you think you can find out the answer to it? Said the March Hare.
Exactly so, said Alice.
Then you should say what you mean, the March Hare went on.
I do, Alice hastily replied. At least I mean what I say. That's the same thing, you know.
Not the same thing a bit, said the Hatter. Why, you might just as well say that I see what I eat is the same thing as I eat what I see.
You might just as well say, added the March Hare, that I like what I get is the same thing as I get what I like.
You might just as well say, added the Dormouse,
which seemed to be talking in its sleep,
that I breathe when I sleep is the same thing as I sleep when I breathe.
It is the same thing with you, said the Hatter.
And here the conversation dropped and the party sat silent for a minute, while Alice thought over all she could remember about ravens and writing desks, which wasn't much.